What is good, YouTube? It's your boy, ThatGuyTy, and I'm back with another fucking leg day. It is Monday. It is 4:25 p.m. and it's a goddamn leg day. If you don't know what that means, I'm just about to go crazy. Oh, the puppy! I'm just about to go crazy in that gym. Just because it's Monday does not mean that we take it easy. Just because we have some time does not mean that we... Just because we had the day off yesterday does not mean that we relax. It does not mean that we take this day to ease into the week. No. It doesn't matter if I just had a day off. It doesn't matter if it's my first lift of the week. It doesn't matter. None of that matters. The only thing that matters is that I have the opportunity to go out today and get better. I have the opportunity to go out today and work hard. I have the opportunity today to go out there and get what I want and start to build the dream that I've been having, right? And that's the kind of outlook you have to have on every single day. No matter what kind of day it is, no matter what day of the week it is, no matter what you're doing that day, just think, I'm going to get better. Because if you're constantly trying to get better and you're constantly trying to, you know, improve upon whatever it is that you do consistently, odds are, you're probably going to freaking improve. Right? Now, whether that's a little bit or a lot of it, depends on, you know, a lot of things. Freaking depends on lift style. It depends on what it is you're trying to do. Depends on how you're trying to achieve it. Depends on where you're trying to go. Depends on, you know, the kind of situation you're in, both mentally, physically, financially. Like, there are so many things that play into how quickly you're going to achieve a goal you have, right, that you can't control. So what does that mean for you? That means you need to focus on the things you can control. Focus on how hard you work. Focus on how disciplined you are. Focus on the ways that you achieve what you're trying to achieve. Focus on the ways you go about talking about what it is you're trying to achieve, right? If you're going around just talking about how good you are and flexing and bragging, right, and you're not really taking any accountability or being humble about any of it, I mean, realistically, what's going on? How are you going to say that you're in any way getting better or improving yourself at all if you're just sitting there bragging, you're just sitting there being egotistical about whatever it is that you're doing? I mean, for me personally, I could not do that and then say that I'm getting better. Because in my opinion, being egotistical and being too full of yourself is a sign of weakness and a sign of immaturity, right? There's no way that... My car says service shifter. I don't know what that means. There's no way that you should be stuck in the same place that you were, or if you're stagnant, that you should be headstrong, be talking about yourself so much, be so looped up into whatever it is that you have going on in your life that you forget that, you know, whatever it is that you're trying to achieve should be the number one goal, not where you're at right now. That's not the end result. Right, you should always be wanting to get better or improve in some kind of way, right? There's no way that you should be content with where you are, ever. If you ever become content, you become lackadaisical. If you become lackadaisical, you become inconsistent. And inconsistency leads to falling out of what you wanted to achieve, right? All the work that you put in, all the time that you put in order to get to a certain place, if you become inconsistent and lackadaisical, you're going to lose all that progress. You are, and it's really about, you know, keeping the progress, continuing to be strong, continuing to be great, continuing to try and find ways to improve yourself consistently, and then not backing down when you do improve. Because when you do improve, man, it's going to be a great thing to see. You're going to be very proud of yourself, man. Very, very proud. So, yeah, that's enough for my intro car talk. The camera's starting to shake, and I'm starting to get frustrated. So we're going to see you guys in the goddamn gym. All right, first movement, my hamstring curls. By the way, Future dropped, so that's what I'm listening to for probably the majority of the stuff is new Future. So far, I'm fucking with it. I mean, I think I only added two songs to my playlist. Yeah, three of five. So we're on six right now. This is too fast. Machine. Okay, so far, this kid's 4 for 6. Guys, this is definitely gonna go my playlist. Hold on.
Oh,
I'm gonna switch this up. Okay. Alright, two more. That's really nice. For all you guys that ask on Mondays what time the Steelers reaction comes out, they're always gonna come out at 5:30 the day after the game. If you guys follow my Instagram, which is linked at the in the description of all my videos, and I think it's in my bio too, but if you guys go follow that, I post every day what I'm posting that day and what time. It's always 5:30 p.m. though, so if you ever don't know when I'm gonna post that day, it's probably gonna be 5:30. Alright, so two. Maybe just as good, if not bad, set one. Okay. Eight days. I'm gonna drop it one and do one more. All right, one more. But you help me forget that you made me remember. My heart cold as December. Learning to love myself, I've been alone every weekend. They say he's out of breath because he's been running from demons. And I've been thugging dolo, lay in my bed and cut off my phone. All right, one more. Let's go. Then we're gonna do some. We're gonna do some glute ham raises after this. If you don't know what that is, get with the program, man. You guys like the view? Be honest. Glute ham raises next. I haven't done these in a long time. Not a long time. No, it's been a while. All right, we're going to do 3 sets of 12 here, but we're going to do them very slow and controlled. By the way, love music, but we're watching some football too. Got to make sure we watch the Bengals lose. Hopefully the Commanders can knock them off. Come on, JD. Jaden Daniels. All right. my fucking balls is being crushed. Oh, that was really nice. Holy shit. Haven't done this in a while. I fucking love it. All right. Two more. Washington. Fuck. Okay. One more. Whew. Oh my god, guys, DeMar Hamlin has got an interception. This nigga literally died and then got an interception. This is unbelievable. This nigga DeMar Hamlin's crazy. That's insane. Bro, just imagine dying and then getting a pick like the next year. It's just insane, bro. Alright. Anyways, we got one more. And then moving on to Cavs. Just standing calf press and then quads after. If I can get this damn Bengals game to pop up now. There we go. Holy shit. Ooh. Oh, fuck. Okay. All right. Ooh. What a tackle. Oh, my God. Calf rest. Oof. All right, just two sets of calf rest. Don't overdo it. We're going to do goblet squats next. Goblet squats. Whew. All right, three sets. The first one is going to be with 85. I did 150 and it was really easy. So, I mean, we'll see how this feels. Whew. Alright, satisfied. We'll leave it there. Evan McFrosty's not so cold. Just missed a field goal. 48 yarder. So McFrosty missed. 7-7. Come on, Jaden Daniels. Go catch you a dub, boy. All right, we're gonna move on to front squats. That was a good two sets. I can live with that. Okay, two sets of front squats. For front squats, this is moderately heavy. I don't know why front squats feel so much different than back squats. But I mean, shit, we're still gonna do them because you always gotta switch it up, man. But yeah. Let's do it. Oh yeah, the Commanders just scored again, so shout out Commanders. Fuck the Bengals. I almost called them the Redskins. Cancel me. That's good. Play sessions. Alright, two sets, full stack. Let's fucking do it, then we'll be done. Oh. Okay. All right. Here we go. Oof.